Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Hexyz 4. Last time, we abandoned all of our other party members, so let's try and go through the Tower of Judgment all by ourselves. Now, the problem with being by ourselves in the Tower of Judgment, I mean, not only can we... Well, are we severely underpowered now, but also we don't have Ralu, which means we can't get most of the... Well, maybe not most, but we can't get a lot of the treasure in here, so we'd have to come back here later anyway. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to bypass all the enemies in here for now. We'll come back here later. Not that the plot will direct us to come back here later, but anyway. So let's see, we made it here. I'm thinking if I want to do this or not. Nah, we'll just go to the end. I'll worry about that foresight later. There we go. Yeah, if you don't have the Peace Mantle or Illusion Cloak right now, well, it'll make it more interesting for you to find your way to get through all this. But yeah, we're already at the end here, so pretty easy. Let's see. Okay, let's equip all your good stuff again. Let's see here. Oh, right. Done. Let's see, let's go with... Might as well take the best one, and Mercurio Gem. Now, one thing you can do while Levant is alone here is you could max out the Holy Cravando on attack up to level 50. And then when you get other Ragnifacts, they'll come back in with a lot more attack levels. So if you want to do that, you can. I'm not going to, though. I'm going to save my... Well, not so much save it for later, but... Well, I'm just not going to do that, okay? Yeah, pretty much. You're just like that guy. For boss time.
Can we win?
But yeah, really, that probably would be a good idea to max out the Holy Cravando on attack power, because that would really help out your other Ragnifacts there. But the thing is, once you get up to level 30, the attack power of the Holy Cravando is pretty well... plateaued. I mean, you're not going to get that much benefit out of it. I mean, if you could get it up to level 50, hey, go knock yourself out. But me personally, well, another reason why I don't want to do that is because, like, when I first beat the game, I didn't, like, that was about where I was, and about my attack power in the 30s there. And I figure anyone who's playing along, or perhaps just playing the game and just looking up a video at the end of the LP or whatever, probably not going to be nearly as advanced as I would be if I did that. So I'm trying to keep myself from getting too overpowered, even though, yeah, I pretty much already am, but... Well, whatever. Altair, huh? Have I heard of that place before? In this game, I mean, not Final Fantasy II? Oh, yeah, they were kind of talking to us about it. Yeah, pretty much. They were working with the enemy. What do you mean? Oh yeah, that's right. You kind of became a monster there or something. Might as well just give up. Pack up. Oh, wait, no, you can't go home. I was going to say pack up your bags and go home, but now you can't go home, can you? But I could kind of see what was going on, even if you took over my body. Yeah, that doesn't exactly sound like the best plan. Well, then why don't you get out? How can it be lonely in there? You have a ton of different forces inside of you. Well, you're kind of dead. You're a part of me now. Yeah, pretty much. Oh. Sure, why not? Uh-oh. Three of them this time. Totally unprepared for free. Or three. For free. Since there's really no money in the game at all. Uh-huh. What do you mean, save you? Well, it just happened to be at the right place at the right time. Because it's a really, really damn good sword. And it keeps me alive. I don't think so, pal. This is my body. For boss time!
You cannot control me!
Okay, so now we are fighting Levant's monster form, I guess. What is this, like Darth Vader versus Anakin Skywalker or something? I don't know, but a good Divine Barrage takes care of the job anyway. Well, that didn't exactly get rid of him. Oh, hey, it's... what's her name? Ah, Philia! Yeah, haven't seen her in a while. Well, what do you mean by that? He's kind of dead. I kicked his ass. Not much I can do about it. I'm kind of a monster, and if I tried helping, I'd just get controlled again and everything. Wait, what did she say? She said something about reincarnation I glossed over there. Oh. What about reincarnation? You're not gonna tell us, are you? Well, we'll learn more about that later. Oh. Wow, that was easy. Where'd she send us, then? Oh, wait a minute. Haven't we, been here before? What, we're starting over again? Huh, she sent us back in time or rewound us or something? Well, anyway, we're right back at the beginning there. I wonder if you can get some of the treasures here if you didn't get them earlier in the game. Though, without Rally, we can't force scan or do anything, so I suppose it'd be kind of hard for us to do anything with that. What's going on? As long as he's inside of you? Oh, that's weird. How many forces do we have around here, anyhow? What do you mean? Well, I have to think about this one carefully. Well, there's not that many of us. To make life more interesting. With war and killing each other and all that stuff. Well, technically there's two with the light and dark sides now, but... and there's more of us than there are of them. Then it'll be just us. Hmm. Yeah, win faster. I don't know. I'm gonna say that winning faster will... Now you're just talking crazy, Levant. No, he's not a god. Well, then why did you ask me? But yeah, I have a feeling that picking winning win faster will tilt the vessel towards destruction. Maybe that's just me. Call me crazy, viewers. But, Oh. What's with that knowledge? I wonder what he's talking about. Well, you want to learn more about that, you'll have to play Cecilia's path. Yeah, I guess we kind of learn a bit about that on Levant's path too, but they go into it a little more on Cecilia's path. What do you mean? Oh, hey, we're back. Hey! Did you bring the squirrel with you? Hey, all right, she did. I thought Ulu was hiding behind her. Oh, it is Ulu. I thought it was Ralu earlier. Sorry, viewers, I always get the two of them mixed up. I need to find a way of remembering that. Maybe just that, like, Ulu and Irene's name both start and end with vowels, but Cecilia's name starts with a consonant, like Ralu. Yeah, that might work. Well, yeah, that is true. Oh. Well, exactly. You should have never left. Himself? Well, he could have become emperor. I would think that would be more honorable. Oh. Yeah, I suppose not. All at the age of 18. It's all downhill from here, Levant. Or however old you are. What's a lie? Oh. Yeah, I suppose that's true. But then the world would come to an end. What, we're gonna depend on Cecilia to get the job done? Well, she's been doing this pretty good so far. What do you mean? We don't. Well, I mean, most humans don't. I mean, you and I do, but... Aww. Being human helps. What do you mean? Uh-oh. Determined music time! What do you mean, into Rosenbaum? They're kind of invading us. Oh. Yeah, I suppose. Alright! And since we... resolved all of our inner demons or conflicts or whatever Philia did to us, I don't know, but we get a new force burst that I'll probably never use. Everyone else gets a new Force Burst as well, or pretty much everyone else. And, yeah, we don't really care about Hex's charge being increased to the maximum now. But the other thing that they don't tell you about is that that also increased the maximum attack and residence levels. Maximum attack is 99, maximum residence is 50. That's huge. So that's pretty much the really important part. Are we too late? Let's find out. But for now, it's just Levant and Irene. So let's see what we got going on. Levant, let's see, you want to be on those. Let's see, Veteran's Mantle. I'm gonna put you on... Oh, no, I should put you on the Hyper Fast deal there. Let's see, Mercurial Gem is good. Shine Trail, get a Necrozawar going for you. Let's see, Hate. Oh wait, did I? Okay, good. I was just making sure I took him off the Peace Mantle there. Okay, so Stardust Cape is good, Swift Boots are good, and Lucky Lenses. Alright, let's heal up and see what we got going on here. One thing you can do is, well, you're gonna see a whole lot of soldiers around here. And, well, if you fight them, you can get more of those Royal Liquids. So, I'm gonna do that on my way down, that is. Or I could just not fight them. There are some soldiers to the left and on the other side of Gultchfort, but there's really no point unless you need to farm more of those Royal Liquids. One thing you should keep in mind, though, is that if you don't have 10 Royal Liquids, this is your last opportunity to get them relatively easily. Otherwise, well, you're not going to be able to fight these guys again. They'll be gone from the Spirit Forest. There actually is a harvest point later on where you can get the Royal Liquids, but it's still only one at a time, or maybe a few more. But... and you know what? There is one more thing I forgot to do. Not that it's really important at this point, but I do want Irene in the front there. Can I? No, I guess I can't move them apart from each other, huh? Okay, well, I'll just leave that as is, then. Whoa. Turn around, man. Or maybe he won't notice me. Yeah, he didn't notice me. Man, looks like everyone's just slaughtering each other here, but... Well, it looks like we made it to the end just fine here. But can we defeat Bon, end the war, and save the non-human race from total extinction? Find out next time on Let's Play Hexyz Force. This is H.G. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day.